Hi everyone, and welcome to our first lecture, the lesson on real numbers. Since we are all here for algebra and to get to better basic math, but it's really important that we start off with that goes into these variables, what goes into these functions, and that of course is real number. So from my experience, people come from different backgrounds with this, and they have different definitions, they have different terminology. So it is extremely important that we all sort of start off on the same page. And one thing I want to show you is that the real numbers, often if I ask people to draw this and represent this, they draw a number line, and that is perfectly fine for most purposes. So you put zero in the middle and you have an infinity off on the right and the negative on the left. But I think this diagram, this picture hides so much important information and really doesn't get into the subtle nuances of what different kinds of numbers are out here. So I would like to sort of walk through and talk about different kind of numbers. So let's treat this as almost definition. You don't need to memorize this right now, but keep them in handy. I would recommend taking notes as you go for new definitions. In particular, always think about referencing them later, yeah? And also examples of things that are and are not those terms, okay? Okay, starting off first with something called the natural numbers. Here's my exercise to you. You just pause the video and count to 10. Yes, I am very serious. You please pause the video. I will wait for you and you count to 10. Even if you want to say it out loud, here's my guess, no matter where you are in the world, that you have started at 1, 2, 3. You know, my little daughter, she can count to 10. Sometimes she skips 7, but we are working on that. So she starts at 1. So actually, there is no real reason to start at 1, you know. Would you be wrong if you said 0, 1, 2, 3, or 7, 8, 9, 10 in this way? Well, I didn't really specify a starting place, but it's a very natural place to start, you know, and go sort of 1, 2, 3, 4, and you count your way up in this way. Actually, these numbers are called the natural numbers. If you think about it, and we are counting with our fingers, of course, we started at 1, then 2, and 3, and in this way. So back to million years, let's assume that we are cavemen now and we are counting how many will the mammoth we killed this day, and we take our rock and we etch it into the cave. We go 1, 2, 3, yeah, this is a naturally great place to start, you know. So these natural numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which we denote this by n with a double bar on the left. Now, fast forward from the caveman time to sort of India, you know, each in India about also they think about nothing. So the next number that entered the number system was 0. Now, this is not an obvious jump, and it took a very long period to get here. And practically, it is quite difficult to symbolize and formalize and also conceptualize nothing, absolute nothing. We have here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and off we go. When you add 0 with you have created the set of whole numbers. I remember whole because of the O in the whole. And of course, 0 looks like an O. Yeah. So we have the set of whole numbers, and that set is noted as this W with a slash to denote the set of whole numbers. Yeah. Fast forward throughout human history, and start trading with different civilizations, and all of a sudden you owe me money or coins or whatever it is back then, rocks that they traded, who knows. So if you owe me something, you can have a debt. And thereby, after zero came negative number. Now, you know, there's no limit to how much you can be in debt. So we go on this ... minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. You can, suddenly you have profits. And now we have started to start to from the larger system of numbers that we know as integers. This set of numbers is called integers. But beware, be careful here for different reasons, you know. Actually, we do not denote this set with the letter I. We denote it as Z. Ask why? It is because if you speak a little German, if you sprinkle as a little Deutsch, although ich bin spreche ein bisschen Deutsch, so if you go to the history, this Z comes from the word Zahlen, which is a German word. You know, a lot of math, the fast math textbooks, a lot of universities that have a lot of mathematicians were basically from Germany and France. And so you will often encounter a lot of German influence into the symbols that are in or the language or descriptors vocabulary of mathematics. So here's the first one, Z for Zahlen. We don't use I. We tend to save I for interval. A little interval around the numbers. So I does get used, but it's not here. So Z is integers and this is Z. And if I want to talk about some particular element, so I'm going to use some symbols here, by the way, you know. So I wanted to say that 1 is an integer, yeah, but I wanted to remove the English sentence that 1 is in Z. So look and feel of this, and I wanted to write this in symbols. I would use these symbols that looks like little e, but it is not an e actually. It is called epsilon. So I would say 1 is an element of Z. 1 is a member of the set Z. So this symbol, you might think of this as an element of, and certainly you can write things that are also not an element, yeah? So I could say, for example, that 0 is not a natural number, and you start to get into more of the symbolism of math than writing out full sentences in this way, which is a bit more common now after integers came into the pictures, okay? As always, time move fast. So here in Egypt or Greece or some ancient civilizations, and start thinking about architecture and beautiful buildings and ratios, and you get yourself into the set of rational numbers. Well, rational numbers are ratio, or sometimes it's called fraction of integers. Here I express it as A over B, and then I wrote a couple of things. So the so we have this so far is the set of all numbers A over B, where A and B are integers, okay? And I am allowed to pick any integer I want, say 2/3 or 1/2, 3/5, pick whatever you want, as long as, of course, and I think we all know this, that you can't divide by zero. So you are not allowed to pick your denominator to be zero, yeah? Any other values are fine, as long as your denominator is not zero. So these are called rational numbers. The symbol to denote these ratios is not R. Well, why can't we use R? Okay, I will let you know later that we are going to save this for some other set of numbers. So here we have to come up with another clever way to say ratios or fractions. And even we cannot use f also, because we are going to use f for functions later. So we look up in other words in the thesaurus and we come up with q. Yeah, so here q stands for quotients. When you write a numbers 1/3 or 2/3, remember that you are dividing 1 by 3 or 2 divided by 3. And in this way, you get quotients, yeah? So Q is our set of rational numbers. And over here, this symbol is called bar, and which by the way means such that. So the way that we have this, that we have Q, which expressed as a set of rational numbers, where A and B belongs to Z, and the denominator B is not equal to 0, okay? Well, it's a very famous result that not every number is rational. You may heard about pi, that cannot be written as a fraction. So we would say, of course, that pi is not a rational, or pi is not an element of Q. So when you are not rational, some like this, that you are also called hard about exponential function. So these are little bit scary. All these numbers cannot be expressed as a fraction. So these are not a rational numbers, and thereby they are not an element of Q. Okay. Once you have all your rational numbers there, when you want to start to talk about the more complicated numbers, pi, square root 2, e, pick your favorite scary number, then that is when you get to the real numbers. The real numbers is our big world or universe, is where we going to hang out for the most of the part. But I want you to show the structure that happens inside of this universe that's not obvious from the number line. Actually, real numbers is a little difficult to define, you know. If you ever take a more advanced courses on real analysis or calculus, so you do this officially. But here I am going to sort out of hand a wave of a little bit and see any number with a decimal expansion that allows me to talk about. So let's say about 5, right? Because 5 is, of course, is like 5.000 dot dot dot. Or I can certainly talk about pi, which is 3.145. So every thing like this, which has some decimal representation, is a real number. I want you to stare at this for a second, realize that as we are developing a larger set, we haven't lost any numbers along the way, isn't it? This is an extremely important observation. I want to keep all my previous contributions to the number system. Yeah. So when we went from natural to whole, it is 0 plus everything we had. Yeah. When we went from the whole to integers, it's negatives plus everything we already had. Next come rationals. See, we can think of every integer as rational. Yeah? Okay, how to do that? Well, how do I think of 2 as a fraction? Very simple. It is just a 2 over 1, isn't it? How do I think of a rational number is a real number? Well, I would take out the calculator and figure out its decimal representation. So, say for example, 1/2. Which is nothing but 0.5, yeah? 1/3 is 0.3333 recurring decimal. So we can always, you can going to sue me and I am not dividing it by 0. So we are turning a rational number into a real number, and you get everything along the way as it is. What I like about the number line is that it's short, it's sweet, and it is simple to think about it, and that it is definitely useful sometimes. But From my personal point of view, I don't think it gives us the true picture. Let me draw you a different world, a different universe of numbers, just so you can get a feel of the structure of the real numbers here. We said the very first level, the simplest level, are the natural numbers. And inside the natural numbers, we have to remember that we have started 1, 2, 3 in this way. Then when I add 0, I get this extra layer, which are my whole numbers. When I start to add negatives here, I get another layer, which is my set of integers. Keep going and form we fractions or ratios or quotients of integers, and you get rational numbers. Finally, including numbers like pi, e, or any other decimal expansion may or may not be a fraction, and you get the set of real numbers. And these delineations, these lines, these separations are not trivial, you know. There is a reason why we draw the line. So, for example, what is a whole number that is not natural? What some number that lives in the second layer? Well, 0. Yeah? What's an integer that is not a whole? So, over here we have minus 3, minus 2. These are different layers where different numbers live. What's a fraction quotient that is not an integer? How about 2/3? How about negative 3/4 to make this? Of course, there are infinitely many choices, and you can pick any fractions randomly. Then, what's a real number that is not a fraction? Well, pi is a famous example. How about square root of 5? How about e? Well, have you seen this before? This is like 2.718 dot 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 dot. So there are lots and lots more. And there are different levels of layers to the structure of real numbers that are certainly not obvious by just drawing the number line. Okay. So if you want to write this and in a set notation, we tend to write this, if you want to be a little more formal about it, using the subset notation. So we say that n is a subset of w, natural numbers are a subset of the whole w, and the whole w is a subset of the set of integers z, z is a subset of q, q is a subset of r. So precisely this is the world, this is the universe that we will be focusing on in this class. This is what I want you to know. I want to emphasize this thing. So if I start talking about integers, I want you to have in mind what they are and what they are not. I talked about rational numbers. What I want you to show that why square root of 5 is not rational. I just want you to have this in mind. What these definitions are and the symbols that are used to talk about the sets or subsets of numbers. Yeah. Now, I am not supposed to tell you this, of course, but there's more out there, and maybe you know this gradually, but this is a big secret, and we will not really talk about them in this class, but there's a few more layers still exists, which we are going to talk in next few lectures. And you will certainly see them. Okay, so keep this sheet handy, and we are going to build up this great job in the first lecture, and see you in next time. Till then, bye.